Marley from the Energy Boutique with your energy forecast for Monday, October 18th. So we will have the moon moving out of the Piscean energy. It started its void of course transit late last night. It will be locking in to Aryan energy around 7:05 a.m. this morning. So I am going to say, pay attention to your dreams. This is likely going to be interrupted sleep. It's either insomnia or you can't wake up. It's either either or, right? The moon in Pisces typically puts us in a deep sleep, really connects us to our unconscious self to really hash out some of the issues that we can't deal with in our waking life. Very revealing in our dream state. But that Aryan energy is hot. It's fiery. It's spicy. Doesn't want to sleep. Doesn't have time to sleep. There's new experiences out there. There's new passions out there. There's exciting things that we just don't want to sleep. And for many of us, we are going to feel a sleep disruption, likely midway through the night. Regardless, the moon in Aries is setting us up for a brand new energy. Where it is that we've lost hope, where it is we got a little bit depressed, where it is we want to escape life altogether, the moon in Aries typically picks us up and dusts us off. We get a little bit passionate again. We aren't so much looking back as we are definitely looking forward. This also puts us in the full moon window. We will be having the full moon in Aries on Wednesday. And so we have to expect that the energy is intensifying. The energy is building. We are going to be illuminated to a lot of new ideas, new emotions, new thoughts, likely coming from the not so light part of our being. And it's going to put us in a position to really see some new paths, some new opportunities emerge that we wouldn't even have contemplated maybe even 2 days ago. So it is going to be a little bit of an aggressive kind of day, especially where Mondays are ruled over by the moon. Once we shift into that Aryan energy, you best believe we're going to be revved up, fired up, ready to go, ready to take life on, brand new attitude, and hella aggressive. So there are 8 aspects taking place today. 5 of them involve the moon. Right out of the gate, and another reason of why I think we're going to have some disrupted sleep issues, is because very early on in the waking hours of the day, Jupiter, the planet of growth and expansions, blessings and abundance, is coming out of its retrograde and going direct. Now, this is going to be a very subtle shift in energy, but we're definitely going to feel like something is different. Lucky for us, Jupiter restores our faith. Jupiter shows us the silver linings. He really amplifies the wisdom that we now have to go ahead and start applying to our waking lives. Retrograde is when the energy is in the inside of ourselves, the inner healing work needed. When we go direct, we take all of the things that we've realized, we start making changes, taking action in our physical realms to align with what it is that we now know to be true inside of us. So Jupiter going direct, you best believe this is going to feel hot and fiery, very extreme, very intense. We could be a little bit manic. We could be a little bit extra. We could be overly dramatic. It's going to be a nice change. Even if we're going to have to take ourselves down a couple of pegs later on in the day, it's going to be a nice change from the depths of the darkness that we have been wading in. The moon is going to go ahead and make a little bit of a tension point with Uranus. Now this wakes us up. This wakes us up in a totally different way because of course Uranus is the great awakener. He shakes us up. He's retrograde in Taurus energy, really shaking the foundations of our personal relationships, our worth, our value, not only within ourselves, but in our finances and resources as well. And of course, doing a major transformation to the goals, to the dreams, to the vision that we thought we had, that now because of new elements, new information, new details emerging, we had to revise our plans. The moon bumping into Uranus in this way is really pushing us to open our minds. We're going to get a little bit of help with that here later when Mercury goes direct. But for right now, Jupiter is opening our minds, opening our perspective, renewing our faith, renewing our confidence, having us focused on the silver lining, having us focused on what is to come and the possibilities of what could be. The moon sextiles, which is a beautiful energy, with the true node. Now we're thinking about our future path a little bit differently. Why? Because we have a different attitude. We have a different energy. We're a little bit hopeful. We're a little bit optimistic. We don't know where it came from, but we're not questioning it because, like I said, it's a very welcome change compared to the depths of the darkness that we have been in. This particular aspect is going to help us rework our vision moving forward. Of course, Jupiter opens our minds to new possibilities and new opportunities. And the true node is saying, okay, well, you got a new vision, you got a new dream, you got a new plan. How are you going to make it happen? Of course, we're still, you know, in this retrograde kind of energy where we had to rework, rethink, re-strategize, recalculate our plans moving forward. And now the true node is just asking us like, hey, okay, you got a renewed faith. You're feeling a little bit more excitable, more positive about things. So what does your vision look like as of right now? And you know what? We might still struggle to find the details, to find the right words to explain it, to find the clarity in what that vision looks like. But Mercury, the ruler of the mental plane, is going to go direct. This is going to be a beautiful thing. First of all, this has been the most upside down retrograde I think we've had in a very long time. We have a lot of communicating that we have to clear up. We have a lot of things to say, a lot of truth to speak. We have a lot really on our minds and on our heart space that we need to get out. And Mercury going direct is going to help us do that. Now, let me just say, definitely check out October's energy forecast for the detailed videos on both Jupiter and Mercury going direct. But these two going direct on the same day, just hours of one another, this is a huge expansion in our minds, in our heart space, in the possibilities of what is to come. This is exactly the breakthrough that we've been waiting for after being broken down time and time again after so many weeks of damage, death, destruction, and despair. So this is going to be a powerful time because the moon goes ahead and makes an aspect with Pluto. And Pluto is just trying to show us where it is that the transformation, the changes need to be taken place. Pluto is just fresh into a direct position. Saturn just went direct. Jupiter just went direct. Mercury is now direct. You best believe we are shifting our mindset into a different realm of thinking, a different plan, a different mission. And Pluto is there trying to kind of encourage us to boss up in ways that we didn't even think we were capable of. And the moon is fired up. The moon is ready to go. The moon is ready to tackle anything that stands in our way. And we've been sitting in the darkness of our victimhood, of our fears, of our doubts, of our insecurities for far too long. And now we're ready to boss up. The moon is going to make a beautiful aspect with Saturn, the Lord of Karma, which is also encouraging us to boss up. Again, Saturn in a direct position now, ready to take action in our physical realms, to build systems and foundations and structures in our lives that are actually strong enough to support the new dreams, the new visions that we're actually contemplating on manifesting now. And this is a beautiful energy because we see the reason of why we had to struggle. We see the silver linings. We see the connection. We see the soul contract. We have a deeper understanding of why the darker parts of our experiences have to happen in order to empower us to a place that we're currently standing in now, aligned with a new mission, a new purpose, a new goal that we're brave and bold enough to actually tackle, to actually put our hands on, take action and make happen in our physical realms. The moon is going to go ahead and make a little bit of a tension point with Jupiter. Jupiter, again, is going to need some time to actually wake up and get up to speed with things. But right now, emotionally, we're just feeling a lot. We can't quite put our finger on it because everything is just happening all at once, but yet it seems like nothing's happening at the same time. Again, there's an interdimensional overlap going on. Please check out the Ascension forecast for a little bit more depth and details about that. But the moon bumping into Jupiter right now is kind of putting a pressure on us where it is we want more for ourselves, where it is that we desire more, we crave more, we want a different life, we want a different partner, we want a different outcome. Well, in order to do that, we have to step outside of our comfort zone of doing what it is that we've always done and do something different to see a different result. Now, this could put a lot of anxiety on us right now, a lot of pressure. Why? Because we're fired up. We want to make a change. Is there a change to make in our waking lives as of right now? Probably not, but we're preparing for it. We're ready. We've reconciled between our heart and our head that it's the right thing to do. And now we're just waiting for the opportunity to arise in our waking lives to actually put into action what we've already agreed within ourselves makes the most sense for us to move forward. Speaking of action, Mars, the god of war, ruling over our physical energy and our action, our drive, our passion, and even our anger, the ruler over Aryan energy, goes ahead and trines beautiful energy, trines with Jupiter. This is essentially when we recognize what actions we have to take, where we're fired up, where we're passionate, where we're being called to pursue new desires. Of course, Mars is in Libra, so we want to do things right. We want to be fair. We want to advocate for ourselves, but we want to consider other people's thoughts and feelings. We have to consider the consequences of our actions before we go ahead and take them, which absolutely infuriates Mars because Mars would rather act first, think about it later. And Libra has been stunting Mars's progress because Libra needs to think about everything first and weigh the pros and cons and get the heart and the head on the same playing field before going ahead and taking an action. And let me just tell you that Jupiter magnifying the energy, the intensity, the passion, the aggression of wanting to see things change like yesterday could put us in a very dangerous situation to act out without thinking and really create a mess that doesn't need to be made. I also want to advise you, be very careful of silly little accidents. With the moon in Aries and Mars all kind of in a kerfuffle, trying to make major moves that, you know, just don't feel like the right time for Mars to make right now, we could be tripping over our own feet. We could be, you know, just finding ourselves in silly little accidents. But the main thing that I want to throw home here is that this is an intense energy. We're in the full moon window. The moon is already in Aries, building towards its full moon peak energy on Wednesday. Mars rules over the moon in Aries. Mars wants to take action. He wants to level the playing field. Jupiter is just, you know, hyping him up, putting the volume on blast, cheering him on in ways that probably shouldn't be cheering him on at this point. And we have to recognize where it is that our restlessness, our anxiety, we got ants in our pants, is pushing us to take an action that technically the universe isn't really ready for us to make as of yet.